Okay, so in this lecture, we continue our discussion on the prime numbers, and I will be discussing a method by which you can find out the prime numbers from 1 to 100. And this method was given by a mathematician named Eratosthenes, who lived somewhere during 3rd century BC, and this method is known as sieve of Eratosthenes, which has been named after him. So what we do is we create a table from 1 to 100. We list the numbers from 1 to 100 as is shown here, and this is the method which I'll be showing to you one by one. So the first step is to cross out the number 1 because it is not prime. So what I'm doing here is I have crossed out, made an X on the number prime. First step is done. Then the second one is encircle 2 and cross out all the multiples of 2 other than 2 itself. Okay, so what we do here is we are encircling the number 2 here, and then I want to now cross out all the multiples of 2 other than 2 itself. So straightforward, 2 multiplied by 2 is 4. I can cancel this. Then we have 6, 8 and 10. Now if I stop here and reflect for a moment, in our previous lecture we had a discussion around odd numbers and even numbers, and one of the special properties of the even numbers that we learned was that all the even numbers are multiples of 2, and we also learned that it is very easy to identify even numbers. All the numbers that have a 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8 in the ones place or the units place, they are all the even numbers, which is the multiple of 2. So I can use that method here to quickly sort through all the numbers, the even numbers, that is virtually the multiples of 2, and cross them out. So I can see this whole column here which has 2. So this number after 62 should have been 72 here. This has been a mistake, so I'm just correcting it. So all these numbers in this column here, they are like 12, 22, 32 and so on. They have 2, so we can cross them out because they will all be multiples of 2. We can do that. Then the next column is the one which has 4 in the units place. Hence I am crossing this here, that is 84 and 94. The next column is which has 6 in the ones place, so I am cancelling those digits, those numbers over here. The next column will be which has 8. So we can straight away cancel these numbers out here because they are all going to be multiples of 2. And of course these numbers 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, they have 0. So we can cross out these numbers because they are going to be multiple of 2. So we have done the second step. Now the third step says that you go to the next uncrossed number and cross all multiples of 3 other than 3 itself. So this is the number 3, and then we have to cross all the multiples of 3 other than 3 itself. So we go 3, 3's are 9, then we have 15 is the next, then we have 21, 27, 3 9's are 27, 3 11's are 33, then what do we have? 37 is 37, no. 39, yes. 13 3's are 39. 41, no. 42, we have already crossed out. 43, 45, yes. 3 15's are 45, so we can cross it out. 47, no. 49, what does 49? No, 49 is not a multiple of 3. 51, yes. 51 is a multiple of 3. 3 into 23 into 17 be 51. 53, no. 55, no. 57, is 57 a multiple of 3? 3 to the 6, and yes, 57 will be crossed out here. Then 58, 59, no. 61, no. 62, 63 is a multiple of 3, so we cross it out. 65, what does 65 belong to? No, 67. Do we have anything for 67? What is 67 a multiple of? No, we don't have 68, 69. Yes, 3 is a multiple of this. 73, 71. No, 73. No, 75. Yes, it's a multiple of 3. 77 is not a multiple of 3. 79. No, 81. Is it a multiple of 3? It is. 83? It's not. 85. No. 87. Is 87 a multiple of 3? No. Is it? We can check. 3 twos are 6. Yes, it is. 89 is a multiple of 3? No. 91. Not at the moment. 93? Yes. 95? No. 97? No. 98? No. 99? Yes. Now we go to the next uncrossed number, which is 5. And then, so we have done the third step. And it says that the next uncrossed number is 5. Cross all the multiples of 5 other than the number 5 itself. So what are the number multiples of 5 other than 5? So it is all these digits which end in 5. I will explain to you this method later on. So we have crossed out all the multiples of 5. And then the method says that continue this till all the numbers are encircled or crossed out in the list from 1 to 100. So I will be doing it in a fast fashion now, just for the sake of time. So the next uncrossed number is 7. And then I'm just scanning through whether if I need to cancel any number here. No. Do I need to cancel any number here? No. Yes, 49. We can cancel that. Then what other number do we have? No, not in this case. Not anymore here. Yes, 77. And do we have any number here? 89? No. 91? Yes. Then do we have 97? No. So then we go for 11. So what we are doing, we are encircling the next number, which is 11, and see if there are any multiples of 11. 12, 33, 44, 45. We have already. Then we have 13. So we just check if anything is left out for 13. No, then we go for the number 19. So I'm now just encircling the numbers. 21, 29. Then we have 31, 37. So I'm just encircling the numbers fast. 41, 43, 47, 61, 67, 71. 79, 83, 89, and here the only number we have is 97. So all these numbers which I have circled here, these are the numbers. I'm just highlighting these numbers here. All these numbers which we have encircled, just forgot to tell you that 53 is also a prime number, I just missed. Even 59 and 97. So all these numbers, including 73 as well. Is there any number that I'm missing? Yes, 17 is being missed or encircling it. Any other number? No. So I will just circle these for completeness. 73. So all these numbers, these encircled numbers, are called the prime numbers, and the cross numbers other than 1 are composite numbers. So this was the sieve of Eratosthenes. Now this sieve that we get is the sieve of Eratosthenes. So this was our discussion on finding the prime numbers from 1 to 100. See you in the next session.